The goblins have to rise up. It's the only way we'll free ourselves from the tyranny of Vorkanar. Vorkanar. If that thing's a real dragon, then I'm a fractal-fanged sky raptor.
see how that turned out. Watch your back, Fate Maker, or you might find some fangs in it.
The more the dice, the better the loot!
Arcane ammo!
I've seen where you're headed. I don't envy you.
This will fire the blast.
You have learned well, my apprentice.
Priestess named Kasara stands before you. She seems to wish you no harm.
What are you doing down here, smooth skin?
Whoa, whoa, whoa. There's a little salt on the way she said smooth skin. I'm offended, I think.
Honestly, I don't even see what the big deal is about having skin. Sometimes skin's too dry, sometimes skin's too wet. Ugh, no thanks.
Yeah, you wouldn't get it. It's a skin thing.
Okay, the next person to say skin is spontaneously combusting!
She said it first!
I am venturing through the depths, and honestly, you're messing up the whole dark and spooky vibe right now.
I am sorry. It has been a very long time since I spoke with anyone. Of course, you seek passage. I can aid you. Here, take this cipher. Now, gaze upon the shrine, and let the words flow through you!
Yah, Drill! Yah! It feels so good to hear a forbidden language come from my mouth.
Only the Coiled may be granted passage through the drowned abyss. This cipher grants you our speech. There are three more shrines. You must intone their words aloud before the doors to the Temple of Sacrifice will open. This was once a sacred place to me and my sisters. Long ago when we shared skies, before the days of chains, before the drowning. You must reach the Temple of Sacrifice. Inside is a light that will grant us passage.
Okay, she's creeping me out a little, and not just because she used the S word.
Yeah, she's got too many proper nouns going on. Chains, drowning, sacrifice.
What? No! She's great! I really want you to like her! You guys trusted the skeleton man just fine.
Yeah, he was a pirate.
Okay, well, with your detect intent ability, you can tell that she's a real sweetheart who's honest and trustworthy, and you love her.
Yeah, but the priestess class has a conceal intent ability.
Casting spells and loading shells.
Miss Reed sounds super evil.
What? You don't know? It could be like a recipe or something.
Yeah, a recipe for people. Okay, fine. I can't resist lore. What's the deal with the drowning?
This city was once a beacon of civilization, a symbol of the united coiled people. But some craved power and allied themselves with the dread void god known as Drill. When he was cast down to the depths by other gods, so too was the city dragged with him.
Sounds like a real bummer.
I was there in the hour of splitting, when our elders cast their lot with Drill against my warnings. Since then, I have stayed as the caretaker of this place, alone for the maddened cries of what were once sisters. It was the bummest of bummers.
So ends their minor part in this grand play.
started.
The words are spoken, and the seal is undone. You may enter the Temple of Sacrifice.
Why do I get the feeling we're the sacrifice?
Quit it! Kasara's cool, okay?
Gah, she's laying it on way too thick. You can see the twist coming a mile away, can't you?
Even after the drowning, my sisters continue to practice profane rituals. I have observed their rites and know them well. We will need to light a fire.
Why would there be a fire pit in an underwater temple?
Because it is a surprise ambush!
You should not! Ordinary fire, seeker of passage. You will need a magical emberjack, a fiery fish whose flames burn even underwater.
Right. But all the fish died when we blew up the ocean.
Fine. Then there's one in a chest right in front of you.
One dead fish. Could it still light a fire?
Wow, Valentine, I didn't know we had a fishologist in the house! It's a magic fire fish! And it's got tons of magic fire juice still all up in it, okay?
Perfect. Now complete the sacrifice.
All right, newbie. Time to give up all your blood.
The fish itself is the sacrifice.
Oh! Huh. Okay.
The temple has accepted your sacrifice. Follow that light. It will take you to the final step of your passage.
See? She didn't want to sacrifice you after all. She's cool.
I don't know. Something about her just makes my
I'm sorry, what was that?
Skull. It makes my skull crawl?
Ooh, are you sure that's the word you wanted to use? Because there's another S word. That you could use. I mean, there's still some time for a spontaneous combustion.
Nope. Just using a completely normal phrase that everyone else uses. Makes my skull crawl. Normal.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Thank you.
remember what to do, right? Because I don't. The bonding ceremony was beautiful. Eldon and I held hands under an archway of leviathan scales, which only barely smelled like a 1,000-year-old fish carcass. He explained that he was transmuting my powers into magical energy or something, but honestly, it just felt tingly. I feel that way a lot around him.
But you do get you're walking right into her trap, right? It's hack writing. Even those other idiots at the table can see through it.
Suspicious.
Look, please, you guys will really like her if you just talk to her a little more.
I am afraid I haven't been completely honest with you.
Ha ha! I knew it!
There is one last sacrifice to make.
Here it comes.
And I make it gladly. I will go with you.
What?
When my sisters fell to the temptations of Drill, I blamed myself. I vow to remain in solitude for my sins. But you have shown me that passage through hardship can only be accomplished alongside friends. I will join your party and aid you on your quest.
No, what? No! There has to be a twist. She's lying. The priestess's maddened sister's attack, drawn by her nefarious spells.
Sisters, I defy you now as I defied you then. You cannot stop us.
Descend into dark! You didn't think I was empty, did you? No time for friends!
Escape!
have given me hope. I will repay you in kind. With friendship.
Yeah, not buying it.
No, dude, she really means it!
May I have a hug? It has been so long since I felt the warmth of another on my skin.
Oh.
She said the S word.
No, she didn't.
She super did, and you said...
I know what I said! Oh, fine! Spontaneous combustion!
I never saw the sun again.
There! Are you happy now?
Here, let's all just go talk to the evil god of the deep, shall we? That sounds like fun.
You did your best, Fate Maker, but you can't save everyone. Not with a bunker master like her.
Didn't really need to kill her off.
Yes, I did, because you made me. And now I have to throw out this whole story I had ready. You know, she had a troubled past, and a yearning for friendship, and a whole redemption arc, and now it's gone!
I don't know. I just thought you were setting up a cool fight.
This is the Bunker Master I know. Welcome to Tantrum City.
That's a big boy! That's a big, big boy!
I was empty, did you?
Set the rules, and anyway, if you hadn't said the S word, she would still be alive.
Oh, so now you care about rules. Here's a rule.
Rule of threes, bitches!
My precious bullets are all gone!
King Mega Turbo Butt as the Fate Maker.
So you're gonna stay?
Like you said, fate doesn't divide us. Fate brings us together.
Of course we're staying. I want to see how this ends. And maybe Kasara could even come back as a friendly ghost.
Nah, she's dead. I'm over it. Quest complete! Do the thing where it says quest complete!
You see how fragile she really is? All that fear, all that doubt. Where do you think she puts it? Right into this world. She has all of the cruelty of a god and none of the responsibility.
Fate Maker begins to wonder, with the world torn in two, can balance ever be restored? Is it enough to defeat evil, or must it be destroyed?